In the 1920s, London, like many major cities, was growing rapidly. And so was its need for electricity. This sparked an historic proposal for a new generating facility, big enough to supply the whole of central and west London. A coal-burning power station in the heart of the capital, in Battersea. There were fears right from the start about the effect its pollution might have on London's famous buildings, parks and works of art, not to mention public health. But despite the warnings, plans went forward. Architect Sir Giles Gilbert Scott, the man behind the UK's trademark red telephone booths and London's Bankside Station, now the Tate Modern, played a key role in the design of Battersea Power Station. Construction began on the first phase in the early 1930s, and by 1957, the power station was complete, boasting cutting-edge technology and hailed as an architectural triumph. The Daily Herald called it a flaming altar of the modern temple of power. Elaborate step brickwork and Doric fluted chimneys soared high into the air, cementing the building's place in the London skyline. Carved bronze figures representing energy and power stood watch on the doors, which opened to reveal a luxurious interior, from pristine parquet flooring to intricate bronze ceiling scrollwork. At its peak, it produced nearly one-fifth of London's power, roughly half the output of a modern nuclear power plant. But after 50 years of active service, Battersea finally closed. Its smoke receded and its chimneys stood idle. Only now are we able to fully comprehend the power station's past, a legacy of environmental damage that we have to acknowledge if we are ever to transform it.